Hello everyone, welcome to this NSX for Beginners tutorial series. In this lab exercise, we're gonna learn how to deploy and manage VMware NSX Manager as a virtual appliance on ESXi host using vCenter Server. So with that, let's get started. As you could see that, this is our vCenter Server. So give a username as administrator at the rate of vsphere.local. Provide password as VMware1. Click here to log in. And as you could see that, we are successfully logged in to our vCenter server. And we have a vCenter server named as vcsa-01a.covmlab.local and vcsa-02a.covmlab.local, which means that our vCenter server configured in a linked mode. Now let's go and browse our first vCenter server, vcsa-01a. In that vCenter server, as you could see that, we have a data center created as GoVMLab Pune DC. And within that data center, we have a cluster created, Compute Cluster A. Let's go and browse our Compute Cluster A. And within that Compute Cluster A, we have a ESXi host named as ESX-01A. So let's go and click on that ESXi host. And as you could see that, this is our ESXi host, which is having a couple of VMs running on that ESXi host. Now let's go and deploy our NSX manager on that ESXi host. To do that, right click on ESXi host, click on OVF template, because NSX manager appliance get provided by VMware in a OVF format, which is another template format. So for that, let's go and click on OVF template. Now here we have an option. So let's select local file, click on choose files, provide the path to your OVA. As you could see that, this is the NSX manager 6.4.5 OVA. Select that file, click on open, click on next, and then we need to provide the name of our NSX manager virtual machine. So I can give a name as NSX manager -02a.govmlab.local. I have already selected GoVMLab DC. Click on next. Select ESX host ESX-01a. Click on next. Click here to scroll down. Click on next. You have to accept all the license agreements, so accept it. Click on next. Now here we need to select storage, where we need to provide the storage for our virtual machine or NSX manager. So I'm going to select disk type as thin provision. Select your data store. We're going to select data storage, data store 1, which is a local data store. Click on next. And here we need to provide network connectivity to that manager appliance. So we're going to connect it to our compute VDS management network. Click on next, and in this particular wizard, we are going to configure a couple of credentials for our NSX manager virtual appliance. So given the credential or password as VMware, reconfirm the password. Then we need to provide password for CLI privilege mode. Again, reconfirm the password. Let's minimize this wizard. Now here we need to provide a name to our NSX manager VM. So we're going to provide a name as NSX manager 02A. Here we need to provide IP address. So let's go and assign IP address as 20.20.20.10. We need to provide subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Click here to scroll down. Provide a default gateway. Click here to scroll down. Then we need to provide the DNS address to our NSX manager. Then give a domain name. So domain name is govmlab.local. Click here to minimize. Now in this wizard, as you could see that, it asks for NTP server. So provide the NTP server address, which is 20.20.20.1. If you want to enable SSH for NSX manager VM, click here to enable SSH. Let's minimize it again. Click here to scroll down. Click on next. And here we can review all of our NSX manager OVF configuration. So just to revise it, what we have done so far. So we are deploying our NSX manager from template. That's the name NSX manager -02A. That's a 6.4.5 version. That's the size of that particular OVF. And then that's the data center. And then ESXi host, it is going to deploy it on ESX-01A. Local data store 1, and the provision is a thin provision, and this VM would be connected to a port group named as VDS management. So click on finish and click on recent task, and as you could see that the VM deployment has got started. deployment is in progress, and as you could see that just like your any standard virtual machine, your NSX manager also get deployed as a virtual machine. Once virtual machine deployment is completed, as you could see that we could see a VM named as NSX manager -02A. Click on that VM. Here you can read out about the notes, what NSX manager is all about. Here you can, in this wizard, you can review all of the network hardware configuration of your NSX manager VM. Now let's go and power on that VM, right click on it, click on power button, click on power on, and as you could see that our NSX manager VM started booting. And as you could see that our OS is booting, a couple of RabbitMQ or other required services are restarted now. So give a username as admin and the same password what we provided during deployment. And as you could see that we are successfully logged into NSX manager VM. Now let's execute the command show version. Press enter, and as you could see that it shows that NSX manager 6.4.4. So far we have learned how to deploy NSX manager appliance as a VM on ESXi host, and then we have learned about configuring all the required configuration for the NSX management appliance, and then we have make sure that our VM got deployed successfully, booted successfully, and then we also got access to our NSX manager CLI interface. Now let me quickly walk you through the NSX manager UI interface and what are the things we can manage through the appliance management UI. So to do that, click on NSX manager. So provide a username admin and give a password. So this is our NSX manager appliance management UI, and we can manage a couple of network and other management configuration, time configuration through this appliance management UI. So click here to log in, and as you could see that this UI shows a couple of options which we can manage from this particular NSX manager appliance management UI. So the first is the summary tab, which will give you the complete dashboard about giving a view or information about the NSX manager. Then a couple of appliance management related settings. Then this is a very important option, manage vCenter registration, where we integrate our NSX manager through our vCenter server. Then we have options for tech support logs, download, backup and restore, and upgrading our NSX manager. So let me quickly walk you through all of these options. So let's explore each option one by one. So click on the summary, and this is a summary where you could see that the first option gives us information about NSX manager, then hardware or manager resource consumption. Then we have a couple of information about services, management components, and then system level components. So as you clearly see that this particular summary option gives us a very good information about our NSX manager virtual appliance and a couple of information about the services which are really important for this for this particular management appliance to be in function. Now click on manage, and this manage tab is all about what are the things you can manage it. So if you could see that on the left side, we can manage a couple of general settings like time configuration, syslog server, network, SSL certificates, and a couple of other options. So let's go and explore each option one by one. So that's the first option where you want to configure time settings or you want to change your NTP configuration. Click on the edit, provide the new NTP server address or the new time zone, and we should be good with that NTP configuration. The next option is about syslog server. So if you want to configure syslog server, click on the add button, give a IP of your syslog server, and then syslog server would be configured. Pretty straightforward. The second option is about network. So you want to reconfigure your NSX manager networking. Click on the network, and the first option is all about changing the host name. Click on the edit, and as you could see that you can change the host name, you can reconfigure the IP addresses and IP, and you can also reconfigure or configure your IPv6 addressing. Click on the cancel. Now this is a DNS server. So if you want to reconfigure your DNS server addresses, click on the edit, and you can provide a new IPv4 DNS primary, secondary, or IPv6 DNS servers. So click on the cancel because we are not going to reconfigure any of the network configurations. Click on the SSL certificate, generate CSR. As you could see that you want to have create your custom generated certificates, you can do that. The next option is about backup and restore. So whenever you want to take a backup of your NSX manager, that's the wizard. From that wizard, we can take a backup of NSX manager. We'll have a dedicated lab or lecture where we'll be discussing about how to backup and restore our NSX manager. The next option is upgrade. So if you want to upgrade your NSX manager, then click on the upgrade. It's pretty straightforward. Click on the upload bundle and you can go and configure your upgrade your NSX manager. We'll have a dedicated lecture where we'll be discussing about how do we upgrade our NSX manager. And the last option is about components, as you could see that NSX management service. Now, this is one of the very important section. That's where every time, you know, once you deploy your NSX manager, that is the first thing you would be doing it. Because as we know that NSX V is tightly integrated with the vCenter server. So we need to register NSX manager with our vCenter server. And that registration can only be done from this particular UI. So click on the NSX management service, and right there you see the option lookup service URL registration and vCenter server registration. So once you do that vCenter server registration, our NSX manager can be accessed from our NSX, our vCenter UI. So in the next lecture, we're going to discuss about this particular option where how do we go and register our NSX vManager to the vCenter server. Now let's go and explore a couple of other options which can be done it from this particular UI. Click on this settings button, the reboot appliance. If you want to reboot your NSX manager appliance, you don't need to go to the vCenter server, go to that VM and then do the reboot. Right there, click on the reboot appliance and we should be able to do that. The next option is download tech support log. That's another very good option, because whenever any issue comes up on the NSX manager, rather than collecting those logs manually, you just go to the NSX appliance management UI, click on the download tech support log, click here, and as you could see that the logs are being collected and they get downloaded right there. As you could see that a tar file gets created having all the required NSX manager logs. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. Click on the about to get the information about your NSX version. So we are having a 6.4.5, and at the last we have a logout to come out from this UI. So this concludes our lecture on how to deploy and manage our NSX manager, where in the first part we learned about how do we go and deploy NSX manager as a virtual appliance, and how do we do the required set of network configurations. And then we also observed how do we get access to the NSX manager CLI. In the second part of this lab, we have walk you through the NSX dedicated appliance management UI and what all the configurations which we can do it from the appliance management UI. Now, one of the very important thing, just to recap, NSX management service. Now, this NSX management service is the next thing we will be doing it after successful deployment of our NSX manager. So stay tuned for our next lecture, where we will be discussing how this NSX manager can be integrated with the vCenter server and can be managed from a vCenter UI. We hope you enjoyed this lecture. Thanks for your time. Please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.